There's no going back. Hoppity whoppity, I'm trespassing on government property. I am fully prepared to cease and desist, to surrender and comply with whatever directions I am given. Because US government property tends to mean men with guns, and men with guns do not like when you mess about with them. Oh boy. However, if I find a lone scientist taking notes in excruciating detail, then I can live with that. I am not going to be intimidated by a scientist. Even an American one. Oh boy, that's the path back, right? I need to orient myself. This is the bridge, and the path leads to the east. Intriguing. Yeah, you get through the gate, and the path will lead to the east pretty much inevitably. There'll be a winding path leading to Uppity Station, as far as I can tell. That's it. Not much more to it. I don't think there are any routes you can take off to the side. It's presumably going to be a fairly straightforward hike on ahead. To Uppity Station, shouldn't I be more careful about this? Oh my goodness, it's glowing. Why is it glowing? Is it supposed to be glowing? What is this? Is it wet? See, the thing is, I could call all of that in, but if we are under surveillance, it's presumably the last thing I should be doing. If anything, I have to unplug the generator. So they can stop monitoring. And of course, ultimately, as much as I may have broken all sorts of laws, these people have also violated quite a bit. They've violated the privacy of these two individuals here. Well, maybe one individual. I don't know which side Delilah is on. And I am quite anxious to eventually find out. Is it electrified? If it isn't, then why not? Shouldn't it be? Well, that's the beyond the gate, but beyond the gate... this is another gate. Wait, this is the other side of the gate? Presumably not. Presumably it is, but from another side entirely. Well, there really isn't anything else here. They're monitoring the soil. This seems largely harmless. That's the two fox lookout. Not much to worry about, really. Tracking what? Exactly. Frequent departure from the fox area. Avoidance behavior. Consult previous data. Unreciprocated desire for copulation. Confirmed. Conflict with other males. Disproportionate food intake. Hey, fuck you, buddy! Alright, I'm calling everything in. The only alternative is to just straightforwardly head back all the way over there without having reported anything to Delilah. Which might be the smarter thing to do, but goddammit, I am calling this stuff in.
Okay, I'm at the site. I don't see anybody around.
Henry, what the fuck are you doing? They can hear us.
I don't care.
Indeed. Oh, I know! I know! Presumably I'm supposed to meet up with her so that we can gain access to equipment that will allow us to communicate so that they won't be able to... You know what? Never mind. Honestly... I have two options. I can head back and meet with Delilah as I was supposed to and head back here later on. Or I can send all this information to her, putting both of our lives in jeopardy. Right till now. I'm going to regret this if I don't call everything in, right? But then again, unless I'm dead, I will presumably be able to come back here. This is gonna send wavefinder, wave receiver, with compass. Locate any strong signal. Green light, target straight ahead. Distance light. Strength of signal. Tone, source of signal discovered. Stop blinking, damn thing. Green light, target straight ahead, yes. Distance light. Strength of signal. The compass that tells you, oh, it's southwest. There's the angle, is the distance. Compass, angle, distance. He's right here. Well. This is the middle of the road solution that really displeases me in every conceivable way, but at the same time, this is what I'm going to stick with. I snatched this bit of equipment, had a gander at what was there to find, and now I'm darting all the way back to Cottonwood Creek to meet up with Delilah. I've already made mistakes. Perhaps I shouldn't have trespassed immediately, or at the very least I shouldn't have called in anything. You know, as I have mentioned before. But even if I don't have information, I have equipment, and equipment matters a great deal. Okay, so the source of the signal. That's... presumably people. broadcasting, right? It can be the case that you can use this to locate anyone using these walkie-talkies. Or it can be the case that they're tracking something specific. I don't know. Bigfoot has a transceiver mounted on it. I don't know. The most logical and coherent explanation is that they're tracking us. They're tracking the signals and walkie-talkies, and therefore they are tracking our location, monitoring our conversations for reasons as of yet unknown. But otherwise, I have no clue. Here's the problem. It's not too many toasters. The problem is that I'm going to be quite miffed if I'm making the wrong choice here. Because this is it, isn't it? This is the ultimate choice. Either I can trust Delilah or I cannot. If I cannot trust Delilah, then frankly calling in all of that stuff was pointless. I should have just cleared away the papers, snatched what I could have, etc., etc. If I can't trust Delilah, I am in an intriguing position. Because I can't heal myself think, I can only heal myself think when he communicates with her. If I can't trust Delilah, that I'm heading for an ambush and a death trap, regardless of whether there's an ambush waiting for her. Which already is a horrible prospect. Selfing to itself. If I can trust Delilah, then I have misjudged her the entire way. And furthermore, aside from that silly sort of thing, which is perfectly excusable as far as I'm concerned, I can just apologize. I've done nothing wrong to her. I may have not been as nice as I would have otherwise have been. Oh, maybe I wasn't sufficiently interested in her in a variety of ways. But all in all, that's really nothing compared to all the atrocities that otherwise could have been done. Where am I? No matter what, I think I'm walking into an ambush. But whether that's an ambush set for me and Delilah, or an ambush set for me by Delilah and other people, I do not know. From quite a bit of intel that I have been able to gather quite recently, it would certainly appear that she's innocent. And I'm going to operate on that basis. If I'm wrong, then so be it. At the same time, if I'm wrong, then I'm going to have a horrible time. Right around, I don't know, a minute or a minute and a half from now. Because I will approach the big tree and walk right into the hands of the very person who has orchestrated all of this. Why did I not snap a photo of that? Oh my god, no! All right, people, here's the... You're presumably not going to hear this, screw that. Oh my god! Yeah, presumably, this entire track is going to be removed because it makes no sense. I'm glad they realized it though. Oh wait, I have that silly camera. Just take a picture of this a secret government installation. I'm sure that'll go over really nicely. I'm sure all the authorities are going to appreciate that move. I'm going to do it anyway. As far as my random thoughts are concerned, at the very least, I will have an easy time locating this place again. Why? Well, but because my wayfinder is going to conveniently lead me to it. Is it a good idea to do this, by the way? Is it really? Because what I'm ultimately doing is documenting my crime. Which I guess is along the lines of in for a penny and for a pound. If bad things are to happen to me as a result of all of this, then I will just compound on the badness of the things happening. Whereas alternatively, if bad things don't happen, I'll have evidence. And ultimately, you have to ask yourself an important question at this juncture, okay? Is this done with the blessing of the US government? Or is this somehow a misappropriation of the funds and a rogue experiment is conducted by some lone lunatic? 8 left. I'm glad I did not waste them. Oh, what's this? How have I not uncovered that? It's a boulder, that's not something you uncover, really. Presumably it's something beneath this. I'm leaving and trekking all the way back to Cottonwood Creek, my goodness. Thankfully I have all these shortcuts unlocked. Where are you? I know I'm walking into a trap, but if I could avoid springing it, that would be great. There was some way for me to actually save my skin here. What, did you leave a note? That's the ski, that's the big tree. Really? We're not meeting over here? I met the big tree. What the hey? Should I head to the Polk Pond? That sounds like a place that would be to your liking. There's the distinct possibility that I've ruined this line of inquiry by going up north first, so I may not be able to find Delilah here whatsoever. Maybe she's on the campgrounds for some reason that I could explain. I do not expect her to actually be here. I figured I would find a note or something. Oh no, my objective has changed. I've convinced the game to give up on the entire idea. Ha ha ha. How ludicrous, but I have. Oh wow, the meeting has been called off. I've taken a step too far. It's too late. I'm not going to find her. Oh my goodness, you can't have the cake and eat the cake. You can't have the device and meet Delilah. Wow! This is a rather disappointing turn of events. But I guess I'll have to live with my decisions here. Tortuous and inconsistent as they may have been. Such is my fate. Most people do one or the other, don't they? They either go north or they head on south over to meet Delilah. They don't do both. You know the worst part is, it's not losing its mind. It's not beeping like crazy. It's not beeping at all. Okay? It's not beeping. No beeping. Zero beeping. Now, I could reasonably report it beeping if I were at my previous location. You know, like a sane person. If I were to remain north and explore everything there. Taking that line of inquiry to its logical conclusion. Instead of half-assing it, reporting it, taking the device, and then making my way all the way south. Then it would be beeping. Like crazy. Oh goodness, fine, I'm going to go north, I'm going to call everything in. Yeah, see you there, I guess. Alright, here I am again. Let's call everything in. And have her berate me for sticking with my plan instead of sticking with her plan. Still, her defensive plan was just going in the exact wrong direction.
Now they're doing something with the soil out here too. It's all gridded off.
Please, Henry, just go where I told you to.
I...
Please, go there right now.
Okay! Actually, you know what? No, it literally says follow the beeping device. It's too late for that now. I was really tempted to actually make a run for it. Actually, you know, go there. Go over the back to Cottonwood Creek. But I don't think that's the right idea. I've just been there. I don't think this dialogue triggers her to get back there. I think I'm just going through the old dialogue that I should have gotten before, as I've decided to stay here. Stick with my plan.
And there's all sorts of contraptions and shit out here.
God damn it, Henry. Fine. I left you a new radio, damn it, but to hell with it. Just do whatever you want.
I knew it!
Oh, well, I'll go get it.
You know what? Forget it. We've danced around it so much now, it's probably gone.
Correct.
But maybe you'll luck out and whoever's listening to us ran down to the market for a gallon of milk.
I figured.
Well, there's nobody here. It's just tents and equipment and... Yeah, that's it.
For now.
Come on, Dee.
No, I'm pissed. You're out there on your own.
Delilah, for fuck's sake, I know I messed up. I wanted to go there. I did.
Why would something like this even be out here?
I don't know, Henry. I'm sure whoever is listening to you right now has their reasons.
But could he tell me?
I'm in their main tent.
Tell me what you see.
It's definitely some sort of monitoring station. Wonder where they are. All of their stuff is here.
They'll be here soon.
Figure out what that thing does and then get the hell out.
Equipment.
This place sleeps three. They've got a row of cots here.
I want to know what that thing finds. Look, you should get out before they come back.
Presumably this game won't let me get caught like that.
I found their main monitoring desk.
You should get out before they come back.
There's a box here with a dial. It has a needle, like it measures earthquakes.
Yeah, all right, okay.
She's not abused.
Yeah, I think this thing is responding to something in this pile of crap on the desk.
Dig through it.
In a moment.
Okay, shit. Got another clipboard here that confirms that they're tracking our movements. The log they've got tracks the movement of four subjects.
You and me?
Yeah, definitely me. And I suppose you too.
What about the other two?
The good ones, the missing teens? No, the male.
Maybe the good ones? What if they were following them last summer?
No way Brian knew. He would have said something.
Yeah, I can't imagine a kid like that could have kept this under his hat.
We'll talk this over and figure out how to get the hell out of here.
Frequent departure, avoidance. Okay. No, that's Dave and the other guy. Okay.
Measuring the barometric pressure, too. Why?
Who knows?
I love the idea of getting that radio that they wouldn't be able to track, but...
It just got lifted out of the space shuttle.
Copy that.
I'm not gonna shut up! And I know they're listening. Whatever.
They've got a map with all sorts of paths and areas marked out on it. There are lines that look like some of the paths I normally take.
Are you positive it's you?
Some of their descriptions seem like uncharitable ways of describing me, yeah.
tracker. Subject: Henry and Delilah. I'm gonna get hit. And I'm gonna get hit hard. Guilt-ridden, susceptible to influence. I'll read that later.
What is it?
There's a folder of reports here.
What do they say?
Their assessments about the two of us. There's stuff in here about Julia.
Like what?
Stuff I didn't tell you. This is...
What does it say about me? You said there was one about me.
And it looks like they've been following me around. What I do when I'm out hiking? Jesus!
Henry, do you hear me?
It says that you and your boyfriend are still together.
What? We're not. They're messing with us.
Yeah, okay.
They are. How do they even know who he is? How the hell does this... I'm so sick of letting these people do this to us. We should just burn the place down. Think about it.
Delilah.
What? Think about it.
I am, and I think it's insane.
They'd be fucked.
Yeah, and how about if that fire comes up the mountain? Or someone were to die in it?
We call it in?
We call it in?
Yeah, maybe.
My God, Delilah, no. No way.
Well, maybe it's not the best idea.
Yeah, let's not do that.
Definitely not the best idea.
Oh, I'm so fucking wound up!
It's all right. I'm just gonna hike back. We have the wave receiver, and tomorrow we can figure out what to do.
I need to take a different path. Of course! This is the moment. I have to take a different path. Because they'll be waiting on the usual trail. But I can get through those paths I've carved out. Yeah, it's right in front of me because I have it in my hands. Wait, how was that my tracker? And how did I have it on me all the time? If it was tracking me. I need to head west. As much as possible. Use the tree to get out. But yeah, it's a... quite a sad state of affairs with me and the tracker. I should have taken the radio. That would have been brilliant. They wouldn't have heard any of this. We would have had a little private conversation about the entire subject. Because right now, they know pretty much everything. Column of smoke? What?
Delilah, there's smoke coming from the site. Yeah, I just climbed out of there and the bridge collapsed.
What the hell happened to you? It's definitely not the best idea.
It wasn't me.
What do we do?
Call it in.
We just call it in like any other fire.
And what about who started it? What about them?
Call them in too.
The person who started it?
Yeah.
We're talking about people watching us out here who are now burning the forest and everything in it around us. I don't know what to do about that.
Except get the hell out.
Yes, get us the hell out of here.
It'd be a lot easier to work together had you gotten that radio.
I'm sorry!
You can figure it out on your own.
I'll try.
Day 77. Whoa, that was it. I didn't even have to go through those alternative routes. I'm sorry I didn't get the radio, I guess. Oh. Really, wave receiver. I get it, but I want to read all of this stuff first. Oh my God! No. Hold on, reports. Observation, Henry. Subject, Henry M, age 39. Program status review, 10 weeks. Observational traits. Comprehensive explorer. Keeps to the path. Prone to anger. Passive. Guilty. Forthright. Guarded. Subject overview. Subject has fully engaged supervisor. Trust yet to be scientifically proven. Yeah, okay. I do not trust the supervisor quite. All signs point towards full cooperation. Update: subject may be aware of test. Suggest we disengage if subject decides to leave his post. Susceptibility to manipulation: 9. Supervisor sign off, e.g. So I am the test subject. And the only sane explanation is that Delilah is in on it. Right? Look at this. Trust has yet to be proven. Subject may be aware of the tests. Or does it? Because my hypothesis here is, okay, there's this little plan where Delilah casually says, oh, we'll have our own private radio where they can't hear us. And that's further down the rabbit hole. That is further convincing me that everything is fine and we are on our own now, no one can hear us. And since I can trust her, obviously, for whatever reason, then if we are all alone as far as this communicator is concerned, if they can't hear us, then we can say anything and everything. We can trust one another, right? But what if she's in on it, working alongside them? In that case, well, in that case, that would be a part of the experiment. She would just be telling me this in order to manipulate me further. There is something that seems to completely and utterly ruin that. However, she's noted as a test subject herself. Program status, annual report, observational traits, reliable, considering alcoholism, observant, charismatic, selfish, skewed perception of personal history, pertinent observation facts, never married, no kids, rarely hikes or leaves immediate surroundings, multiple lovers despite longtime partner named Javier, susceptibility to manipulation, 3. It's difficult to manipulate her, very easy to manipulate Henry. Now let's read all the outside notes. Yeah, those are notes on us. What the fuck difference a day makes? Holy hell, I don't even know where to begin. It's late past midnight, so I'm going to write down everything that happened today as fast as I can. I went down to the lake and found a clipboard and a walkie-talkie. Yeah, and I don't know how to describe it, so I don't know what to say other than someone is listening to Delilah and I. I know that sounds crazy, but someone is out here listening to us and attacked me. They're taking notes about other conversations. We think there might be some sort of study going on. Like maybe we were given these jobs not just to look for files, but to be part of a behavioral study or something. Fuck, I know this all sounds insane. It is insane. I don't know how to explain any of it. Delilah definitely heard someone on our walkie-talkies too. It wasn't just me. I'm rambling here. She heard someone too. I tried calling her a couple times tonight, but we don't want to talk on these anymore. I don't know what we're going to do. There was a perfectly fine solution that I really ruined. I was trying to find the walkie-talkie, but I failed horribly. Alas, alas, alas. Maybe they were the ones leaving the books. I'm sorry, where's the turtle? Henry, where's the turtle? Where's your little turtle buddy? Did you set him free or something? What happy personnel? Okay, yeah, I picked that one up. Government-owned controlled area. I wish powers that be issued us radios that don't suck ass. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Ron and Dave were potentially the guys that were... they were keeping track of aside from us. Are they National Forest Service at all? Not working for them? No, I think that people are being tracked. So many mysteries. I was doomed the moment I picked up that doohickey. That's completely unfair. Should have still been fine for me to return to Delilah, pick up the radio and proceed from there. Frankly, I would have... Oh, this is my jam. Frankly... It's perfectly prepared to do just that. And it all would have been fine, too. It all would have been wonderful. Only the game allowed me to do that, but it didn't!
This receiver just picked something up.
What? What thingy? What now?
I found a device that picks up frequencies. It's how I found the reports last night, and it's going off now.
It just picked up a frequency?
Yeah, what could it be?
I don't know. You gotta find out.
All right, I'm on my way now.
You know what I just picked up?
No.
A fifth of Major Bueno tequila from the creek.
Are you drunk?
No! I am getting drunk!
Don't do that.
I'm serious.
I know. Everything has gone to total shit, but we gotta live a little. You gotta allow, Hank.
No, you're right, Dee. I can't think of any good reason why you wouldn't want your decision-making inhibited right now.
Exactly!
My thinking is, I could stay up all night worried I'm gonna lose my job because of the side fire, or I could not worry and let the chips fall where they may. It's not like there's any proof we were down there.
My thinking is, I'm gonna follow this wave receiver.
Ooh, I like it when you think.
Ay, ay, ay. I'll just leave you alone with whatever these thoughts are. Last thing I need is another big crossword breakthrough.
Radio off. Well, that's lovely. What do I do with the tracking device, though? It can be tracked, but I can't lug it around all the time. Possibly could. The radio is off, so there's no point in trying to call anything into Delilah. Also, yeah, having her thinking impaired really wasn't the best of ideas. Really isn't the best of ideas. She's making this decision as we speak. Seriously, keeping a clear head and just figuring things out would have been very much so preferred. Okay, so the southwest. Actually, I'll head around just to be on the safe side and to mess about a little too. No, there's still nothing in the outhouse. Surprising absolutely no one. Why do I insist on wedging him against all reason? Actually against the outhouse, but never mind. Southwest, can I actually anticipate where I'm going? Presumably the medicine wheel. Is it a ghost detector? Yeah, I guess we could have figured things out with Delilah. That radio would have helped, but once again she has proven herself unreliable. Which does confirm one of my suspicions. It's not that she's behind this. She's just incompetent. Not malicious. I'm mortified. Is it up though? Okay. Let's hope I don't.
What?
Let's get the hell out. The key! The cave!
D, I found some sort of supply bag, light camping gear, some clothes, and basics, but it was alarmed. I think that's what was making the receiver go haywire.
You're okay? It's not a trap or anything?
It's a trap.
Yeah, I'm fine. But there's also a set of keys here. Now, I don't know why they'd be hidden out here. They say Shoshone National Forest.
Last place I haven't visited.
Is that the one in the canyon?
Yeah, it is. Who the hell took them?
And what the hell is in that cave?
Okay, let's just think.
Can you do that?
A woman with a half a bottle of tequila in her belt.
Maybe they're panicking and we're preparing to beat it. The fire must have them spooked.
So why did they leave this for me?
Standing in the dark in the middle of the woods. So, you know, they don't have a monopoly on being spooked.
Oh. Well, you're back in your tower. Maybe you need a drink, too.
I'm not in my tower.
Oh, fuck!
I'm looking at a man standing in your lookout. And it's not you?
It is not me.
Oh, my God. Go.
I'm going.
And well, am I going back to my lookout? Yeah, oh yeah, I'm going to confront that man with my axe, right? No, how dumb do you think I am? I think going to the cave is a better idea. Goddamn gamer sense. I see someone who seems to be where you usually are. By golly, I think if you were there, he would have hurt you. But I'm not there now. Let me make my way over there quickly. So he may get his wish. No! Come on, now I know better than that. I might be heading headfirst into danger, but I know that the eavesdropping. And I'm trying to make use of that information. For one. I also, yeah, maybe heading into danger, but at the very least, I'm not heading into danger in such a way that I'm simply charging at obvious threats. I'm exploring areas that could give me insight into what is actually going on. There's a number of things I could do, and I frankly I think it's not the stupidest of them.
Hey, I got turned around. Is that person still there?
No, he's gone.
I'll call you when I get back.
Perhaps I shouldn't have called in the fact that I'm elsewhere, but if they can track my radio's position, then that's all a bit of a moot point anyway. Hold on, east? Yeah, east, of course, the river's to the west. The lake is to the west, downstream of the river, so I need to go upstream into the cave. I'll investigate what happened back at my lookout point later on. Or maybe I should go there now and investigate that first. I don't know. This game seems to want to lead you places, step by step. And I seem to be taking alternative paths. Despite what I am blatantly told to do. But, as it all too often turns out, what I am exactly not supposed to do, in the most obvious way, tends to turn out to be exactly what they expect me to do, I think. Well, I can't really hide over here, now can I? Not much of a hiding spot. Well, this is a thoroughly disappointing experience. I could just walk down there, really. It's not that imposing. It can be done. You know what? Whatever. Fine. I'll get out. And do the only thing I actually can do. Will I be met with resistance at the top of this mountainous exit? Not really. This is the way back to the lookout, but if these guys want to head to the... Why would they leave that though? There's no reason. They left the backpack and the key. The most reasonable expectation is he's got the device that detects these things. And we put this there. He'll obviously go out and find it. He'll get the key. He'll go to the cave. Exactly as expected. But then again, how the hell can I subvert expectations? If there even is such a possibility. Can I and should I attempt to subvert expectations? I'm glad I put the wedding band on. Seems to have stayed on. Which is great. They didn't set fire to my little tower, did they? Let's hope they did not take my turtle. Okay, step one, investigate the outhouse. Did they take down all the notes? Perhaps I should have... I don't think I needed to take... Oh, right, those were all the notes. Should I have taken a photo of all the notes? Well, here's the thing. If they are all there, then perhaps not. If they are not there, then perhaps yes. But if they are still there... Then I am going to...
I don't see anyone up here.
Take a photo of them.
She was just there.
Left a cassette player taped to my damn door.
I don't even know what to say to that.
Well, let's see what's on it.
I don't want to listen to this one, to take a photo of... You know what? Never mind. Yes?
Talking down at the site. Sounds like it was recorded from somewhere nearby.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah, and it sounds like we were the ones who burned it down and that it was your idea.
No.
We are screwed.
No!
Dee, just don't freak out, okay? Don't freak out.
Oh my God, what the fuck is happening, Henry?
Lady, relax. It's gonna be fine. I've taken... Maybe I shouldn't have gone there to begin with. I don't know anymore.
So your little bender isn't looking like such a good idea under the light of a new day, huh?
No, it isn't, but that's not it. Someone claiming to be Henry in Two Forks called a lookout in another sector early this morning and said that I knew what caused the Wapiti Meadow fire.
That's not me.
So, I just got off the horn with that lookout who's wondering what I know, or that I'm an arsonist, or that I'm fucking losing it. Furthermore,
aren't
I bet
you
don't have the only tape of us from last night, so someone has evidence to back it up. We need to find out what someone's been keeping in that cave.
I'm going down there now.
We don't have a lot of time left out here, and if we don't find some fucking answers, when they lift us out of here, it's gonna be in handcuffs.
Us?
Us? What's this us? You're the boss. I was just...
What, following orders?
Yeah, like Eichmann.
I didn't start this fire. So you just tell them the truth, right? That's all you can do?
Yeah, I suppose you're right.
I know.
Oh, really? I would have expected you to try and take me down with you and say, no, he was totally in on it. In fact, it was his idea. I don't know. My trust is very limited. But as you can see, there are consequences, and the consequence to not taking the goddamn radio is that obviously they have a recording of all of that. Why the hell? Why the hell would she say that, knowing that they're listening? Well, why the hell did I say everything I did, knowing that they were listening as well? Oh boy. So where did my turtle go? Is it still with me, or did I sour the relationship between myself and the turtle? I didn't write down more later. The sun's not up yet. I'm exhausted at daylight. I'm going to head down into the cave in the canyon and see what I can find. I don't know what else to say, really. I know I should probably take extensive notes. Yesterday, I had the thought that maybe I'm not quite right in the head. Just came across me for a moment that I'd be lying if I said I didn't think it for a second. I'm going down into the cave, and I just hope I find something. I don't care what happens as long as I find something. I wonder what will happen if I don't make it back. I'm obviously a little worried about that. I'm not trying to act tough, but what would actually happen? It's hard to imagine at this stage anybody would notice. Susan, my sister out in Maryland, would eventually get a call, and I'd feel bad for not seeing her and the kids for so long. But Julia, it's almost maybe 6 months now. Maybe it wouldn't even register. Maybe I don't even register. I just felt a little panicked though. What if I do register and I just left her alone? In a way, I guess, those playthroughs tend to be the most impressive and emotional. The ones where you mess up slightly and then try to do your best. Because if everything goes smoothly and perfectly, then that's satisfying, but in a completely different way. However, as things are, I've made the horrible, atrocious mistake of not picking up that radio. And as I have mentioned previously, I mostly blame the game. It was only when I picked up that stupid doohickey, presumably when the radio disappeared. If it did. I couldn't find it. Maybe the objective changed, maybe the radio disappeared, maybe the radio didn't disappear. And they just failed to find it because it wasn't an objective, just blatantly out there. But all in all, it was almost perfect, but with all these limitations, well, comes the opportunity to make the best out of a bad situation. Let's just head straight north. East and then immediately north. It's the quickest way to reach the cave. Might as well take it by the outhouse. There's presumably nothing there, right? Get wedged. Oh boy. The thought of that radio missing is going to haunt me. Even more so than those books I've lost to the voracious cave and the hungry ground. I guess that's the biggest mistake so far.
Hey, you didn't actually make that call, right? To the other lookout?
No.
It just stuck in my craw. I let myself imagine how fucked I would be if you'd been lying to me. But now that I asked, I kinda just wish I hadn't.
Hmm.
I don't even know how to call anyone other than you. And please, rest assured, I would have found someone with a better sense of humor a long time ago.
Okay. Thanks.
You know, that I guess that is reassuring, because ultimately if he tells her that, no, I'm a trustworthy individual, she's not gonna necessarily believe that. But this stands to reason. Yeah, you seem to have absolutely no reason to believe that he actually even knows how to contact anyone. Unless he's in on the entire thing, in which case him being a test subject and discovering all these things and then telling you about it makes next to no sense. So obviously Delilah is not malicious but incompetent. Well, not obviously. Most likely. And she has plenty of reasons to trust Henry. That is indeed the best defense. Like, I'm not going to comment. Yeah, possibly suspicious. Oh, I didn't do anything. Yeah, how can I trust you? Like, I haven't been able to contact anyone except for you, and I've been here days upon days. So no, I didn't suddenly get a breakthrough in that department and immediately use the opportunity to rat you out. That sounds like the most sound explanation there is.
What the hell?
I think you're locked in, so your only way out is through the caves.
Delilah, someone locked me in the cave. Is this thing working? Delilah, send someone to the cave, please! Can't give me damn reception.
I could get deception. Reception. I could get deception. God damn it! Deception! I could get reception right outside the gate, but I can't in. What is this? Is that a Faraday gate? Come on now! Yo ho ho, through the cave we. Oh! I'm not climbing down.
Jesus, this is a big cave.
That's a long, steep drop that you don't want to take. Intriguing. Well, Mr. Puwaski. Look at those shafts. Can I squeeze through the rocks and not die underneath the boulders? We are about to find out. I don't think that was a part of the plan, was it? Presumably I was supposed to head down. If they planned this entire thing, locking me in and then me finding this spot in order to get through the cave over through here, then the... Well, then the expectations of this guy's intelligence and survival instinct are, exceed my expectations. This is going to collapse. You can see that this is unstable. It's just going to collapse right underneath him. That's a long drop. Wow. Really? Is that a cave system? So enormous and expansive. Come on, get to the other side, dude.
Oh. Freezing in here.
That's illogical. You're in a cave. Any heat should be pretty much trapped in there. The closer it is to the core, with every single kilometer it gets... Yeah, with every single kilometer. You're not deep enough for it to be incredibly hot. Or even sufficiently noticeably hotter, I guess. Oh boy. What is that?
Is anybody down there?
That boy and that guy. You know, at this point it has dawned on me. Have I possibly lost my mind? I don't think so. Why can't I descend to get the shoe? Yes, it's possible to go down there. Why am I not going down there? Because I desperately want out? Oh boy. Oh my. Well, oh well. Will I even end up once I get out? optimistically assuming that I will indeed make it out. Presumably somewhere with a long drop. So a place accessible only from one side, right? Yeah, indeed. Yeah, I think I can trust Delilah. I don't know anymore. It's still possible for her to be making all of this up, but once again, that seems way too convoluted of an explanation at this point. I think I've reached the threshold. I think I will be tentatively on the side of believing Delilah and trusting her rather than the other way around.
Hey, are you there?
Yeah, what is it? What did you find?
Nothing yet, because someone tried to trap me in there.
You saw someone?
No, someone slammed the gate behind me and then ran away. I found another way out, but if I hadn't, Jesus!
So you didn't find anything?
No. There's a spot where someone had sunk an anchor, but the hardware's gone now.
I don't have any climbing equipment.
I just have my ropes. I'm gonna hike back to Two Forks and see if I can find anything that could double as an anchor to use in the spot.
Well, that doesn't sound dangerous.
Where am I? No, I'm perfectly serious. Where am I? I haven't seen this place. That explains things. Oh my goodness. Were they also trapped there and then got out and then... Oh, whoa. Well, that's quite a discovery. Oh, no more books. How am I going to be able to carry them?
Delilah, I just found an outcropping that someone was using as a little fort. I think it was Brian Goodwin.
Really?
Yeah, he built himself a real castle.
I don't understand this. What must have happened? So what, did Ned Goodwin somehow disappear? And Brian was forced to make it on his own here? Backpack retrieval plan. Oh. Hold on, he lost his backpack. Here's a rope spool and a pulley. Pack contains my rope and our camera. Get boards, rope, rocks, tools. Yeah, that didn't happen, did it? Oh my god, I think I know where he is.
Hey, remember that pack I found?
Back on your second day? Yeah.
I found a plan Brian drew about how he was going to get it back.
Oh, I'm sure it was quite elaborate.
It's some Wile E. Coyote stuff, I'll tell you that much.
He's down the canyon. He never managed. Presumably tried, fell. Oh boy, whoa. Yeah, Brian Goodwin, Hampton Science for... Talking medias? What? How ham radio waves can use medias to talk to people far away? What? What if I told you... Avoid second persons to conversational science. What if I told you that you could use medias in an atmosphere to talk to people far away? You'd probably think I was a liar, but you would be wrong. Medias, the alien rocks that come to our planet from space, can be used to bounce ham radio waves off of... What? Can be used to bounce ham radio waves off of them, and let you use your radio much better than normal. Right now, you are thinking, okay, Brian, this sounds like a movie. Well, Flight of the Navigator is not real, but you are wrong. It is real. It is science. It's possible because of media's scattered communications. My science for the project proves that media's scattered communications is real. But what is it? MSC is a radio propagation mode that utilizes the ionized trail of medias within our atmosphere. Meteors up out of the atmosphere again can create a dense path of ionized particles that ham radio operator can use to establish brief communication paths between operators of up to 1,500 miles away. Are these your own words, Brian? I'm going to test this by having a small chat with a friend my dad made in the army who lives in Albuquerque, New Mexico, 1,000 miles from my house. We are going to try to talk at a regular time, but my hypothesis is that that won't work and we will have to wait for a meteor shower so we can establish a communication. It would be quite intriguing if this was correct and this doohickey was built based on that principle, but I...
Brian was doing a science fair project about bouncing radio waves off of a meteor shower.
Poor kid left his homework?
Yeah. He must have been pretty smart, huh?
Yeah, sharper than a lot of the grown-up knuckleheads I'm used to, yeah.
Yeah, but not smarter than yours truly, right?
Wait. Are you seriously feeling threatened by the intelligence of a 12-year-old you've never even met?
I'm just saying. Could. I'm pretty with it. I'm a pretty bright bulb.
No, you're not.
Yeah, Henry, you're a regular Rhodes Scholar.
Nice. I found an old school folder. Brian was a hell of a doodler. It's a little weird that he'd just leave so much of his stuff out here.
Well, maybe they were in a hurry when they left. Like I said, he wasn't supposed to be out here.
Yeah.
They almost got busted. Brian liked to go out on the railing of the tower and wave at the planes that dump water on fires, and... I got a call because someone thought a kid was up in Two Forks. I lied. And just said it was Ned. If I ratted him out, they would have been forced to leave, and... I don't know, I guess I just felt like I was saving him from whatever shitty life Ned was gonna bring him back to. Not that it ended up mattering.
Intriguing. Presumably defaced by Brian Goodwin. Yeah. Fine, I'm keeping this. Loose stone, I still don't know where I am.
Bunch of rocks stacked up. You made a wall and a perimeter.
God. Yeah, that's perfect.
You know, maybe he made it because he was afraid of them.
Whenever I think of Brian possibly going through this crap, I get sick to my stomach.
Yeah. Sorry. He was in the middle of really sprucing up the joint when they left.
CS. Or GS. Yeah, it looks like a CS. Wow. There's quite a few of these. Oh goody, another one. Neil Black has just exposed the largest underground gambling racket, rambling gacket, in the nation's history. With the murder basking in the glory, it's only when consequences come knocking as Neil Black called on again. Neil Black is a lot of things, but a fall guy isn't one of them. How do you beat the odds when the high-risk sting goes wrong? It's only a matter of time before the powers that be do what they always do, put it all black. Wait a minute, haven't I found this before? Isn't this one of the books that have sank, that has managed to... Might not be. 5 degrees north, I don't know. That's presumably book 5. Oh my goodness, taking this out is going to be a disaster, isn't it? Don't sink into the ground, please.
He'd hide out here to read comics. The black band, his grief is his enemy's sorrow. Everyone this guy loves gets killed, so he honors them with a black armband which gives him superpowers.
Well, that's fucking dark.
Holy comic book, Batman. You dropped the comic book, but where did you drop it? Henry, where did you drop the comic book? And it's gone. I have a problem with object permanence, or the lack of it. Oh, goody! This is why you pick up these things. This is why. It's a lovely sign. Magnificent, yes. A plane flying into the stars. Just beautiful. Oh my goodness!
There's a busted old toy out here. Some sort of electronic game.
Yeah? I like Pong.
Everybody likes Pong.
Gosh, Brian had everything he loved out there.
I don't think he would have easily left. Unless he had no alternatives. And really, really, desperately, absolutely was in a hurry. So much so that nothing. Oh, yes! That's what I needed.
There's some grade A dork contraband here.
You found his pocket protector?
I found a data sheet for one Gladius Silva, half-elf, armor 7.
Classic wizards and wyverns.
Yeah, between this and the map I found in my tower, old Brian created quite the fantasy world.
Gosh, Brian had everything he loved out there.
Yeah, you've mentioned that already. Two-handed weapon. Yeah, this is the fort of Gladius Silva. It's marked on the map. He's chaotic good. Yes! Age 29, clearly. Appearance rugged. Note to the ranger. Now let's read it first. And let's read it like this instead of conveniently. Dear ranger, hi, my name is Brian Goodwin. If you found this note, it should be with a bunch of climbing anchors. Could you do me a favor and return them to me, Brian Goodwin? Brian Goodwin in the mail. My address is 55th Foxtrot Lane, Nebraska. If you tell me your name and address, I will give you a reward for this. You are probably wondering why I left these here. Well, they are my dad's, and I don't want him to lose them. He wasn't a nerd. No self-respecting nerd would write loose instead of lose. Come on now. I don't think you can have an IQ above 100 and type loose. But I don't want to... All right. Instead of lose. But I don't want to do any more climbing on this trip. So I thought I should pretend to lose them. But if you help me get them back, everyone will be happy. Thank you for your time. Thank you, Ranger Brian. The reward will be good. Wow, that might have doomed them.
Huh. Brian stole his dad's climbing gear. His anchors.
That's convenient.
Yeah, it is. I think he was going to hide them in a cash box or something and never got around to it. I mean, he left a note for a ranger to find them and send them back to him in Nebraska.
Because he hated climbing?
Yeah. I mean, it sounds like Ned was pushing him and pretending to lose his anchors was the easiest way to put a stop to it.
I hope it worked. God, what an asshole.
Yeah. Man, that is the sort of thing that would have caused me to catch a beating growing up.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't put it past old Ned.
See, the transcript is fine. It says lose. So that's on Brian. Interesting, but wrong. That gun shall pass maximum voltage. Radio Goodwin, 300 watts. What?
There's a ham radio schematic here, something Brian was working on.
Yeah, I think that was the one thing Ned did do with him. You know, tinkering on stuff like that.
There's also a postcard here from Brian to, I guess, his neighbor.
What's it say?
That he's with his dad and sorry he can't mow his lawn this summer.
Oh, gosh.
And also he was worried his dad didn't know when school started. I'd say that's a lucky break if I were him.
Yeah, that doesn't surprise me. Ned didn't really seem like a, you know, with it dad.
Sorry I can't mow your lawn this summer, but I hope you found a good person to do it instead. Can you write back and tell my dad when school starts, because I don't think he knows. Your friend and neighbor, Brian Goodwin. Wow, this guy. Paul Brian. But I guess that's the fault. Oh no, that was on the D&D map. Okay, that's the kid's hideout. So now I know where I... Wow! Okay, so the cave system, in a very meandering roundabout way, leads all the way over here. So then the only way out is due north. I'll visit Hawk's Rest on my way. Actually, hold on. I want to check if there's anything else of note right around here. I don't suspect there to be anything, but you might as well, and I might as well check. Should I take a photo of the fault? I'm running out of film. Two left. I might have taken one already, but I can't remember. Dude? That's the way out. Are you... Okay. Oh no, now I'm going to have to look for all of these cracks. Come now, don't tell me I can't pick up the book anymore. It's right there! You suck. Bye, little old book. Logos knows I tried to retrieve you, but apparently that's just not possible. That's just not in the cards. Or is it? Can I go back up here and then retrieve the book? No! Can I mess about with it as a physical object and then pick it up? Yes! Yes, I can. Pretty much anything in this game that relies on physics is wholly and irrevocably balked.
What do you think is in there?
In what? In well, in the cave?
Probably something that will kill me. So, you know, just sort of getting myself right with God or whatever there is.
Henry.
They closed the door when they could have just
bashed your head in with a rock or chopped you up with a...
That's enough.
Are you serious with this shit right now?
A hatchet. God, are you sure you want to go back in there?
Honestly, I just want to know. I want to know what is worth doing everything that's been done to us.
Yeah, me too. And not going to jail would be a nice kicker.
Do you honestly think that's... I don't know anymore. I would check my map, but to do that I would have to drop the book. And you know what happens when I try to drop the goddamn book. Oh, look, I... Please don't disappear. I've lost so many of you already. So many of your fine brethren. That's just a long drop. Okay, book. Coming with me. What if he forgets the book up there or something? Nope, he's still got the book. As long as he's actually carrying it, it's fine. So that's the long drop. No way of going back though, unless I go through the cave.
Oh, also, those girls turned up. Looks like you didn't kill them. Nobody did. They took some farmer's tractor for a joyride down in Riverton and landed in jail.
That's good. If they know anything, I'm missing.
Dodged a bullet there.
Yeah. We've got enough unanswered shit to answer for, I'd say.
Please don't disappear. Path west, south, where am I? I need to go north if I want to get out. So I should head south, obviously, right? I think I already headed north. I just wanted to visit Hawk's Rest. But these are no longer uncharted waters, so to speak, right? I've already been here. Of course. So Hawk's Rest is out of the question. But since I have all this crap, and since presumably I took my key with me... I can use the key, but I want to get this book back to my lookout tower first. Hold on. Presumably I'll cut away from this bit. Or will I? I could hypothetically speculate. I could definitely speculate about great many things. What if the kid was right? What if that's at the core of everything? What if he discovered a way to communicate a long distance? What if he discovered a way to communicate with aliens? I don't know. What if he discovered a brilliant way of extremely long-term transmissions to work marvelously. Was he right though? Or was he just mostly delusional? Did Ned Goodwin discover something truly mesmerizing? Or was it all just a pipe dream? Okay, So that's the book retrieved, put back in its place. Now we have to head back and visit the cave. Yet again, it's the last place I can really see. I don't think there's any point in going anywhere else. So it's just north, east. Down the path, all the way back. I think I have two more photographs that I can take. Not a great deal. But should be more than enough if there's one photo I need to snap in the cave. It ought to be enough then. Let's hope it is. Will this device actually point me towards that? What a silly little adventure this has been. Is this a part of the test? All these possibilities swirling through my mind. Because obviously there's always the possibility. There's always the possibility that this all is a part of the test. A further part of the test. How far does it go though? To which point did the test begin? Could it possibly be the case that his wife doesn't actually have dementia and indeed is the one who designed the test and is running it to check how he would react to all sorts of stimuli? There are all these possibilities. Now I could go through there. Was there something to explore over there first? Let's see. Might be able to find Brian's shoe. I could also go down that first initial path. I don't know anymore. I have options. Options are scary. They're giving me choices. Come on, there has to be a... a way to reach the shoe. No. No, Weston, there doesn't have to be. It's perfectly feasible that there's no way to actually go over the... So I need to head back. I have to head back. There's no other way. The single place I can plant the hook. Once again, how much of this has been anticipated? How much of this is exactly according to the plan of these guys? And how much of it is me managing to work independently? Not necessarily against it so much as doing stuff on my own and of my own accord. The protagonist isn't a terribly smart guy, keep that in mind. Okay, we're in the cave. Not just in the cave, but in the cave, in the cave. Gone down the path, in the cave. It's coming, I can just feel it. Something horrible is about to happen. I don't know what yet. A revelation. Am I about to uncover the truth? Am I about to die? Could be very prosaic. What happened here? Long drop down or just drop down here? This one. This means I can climb back up using these moss-covered steps. Oh, if only I had a map of the cave system. This can get very intricate very quickly. Isn't quite. A book!
Guys! This is the book! It has fallen down here! See? I remember this one!
He'd soak up some sun.
There it is! It has fallen through the cave's floor all the way down here. Presumably, I wasn't supposed to find the book here. This was supposed to be an emotional moment. They've ruined it with the glitchy goddamn physics. But I will retrieve this. This is amazing. I dropped two books here, though. One of them presumably appeared in Brian's fort. And the other one is this one. Unless there are duplicates, which is also a possibility. But I don't think that's the case. So if they hackily implemented old books reappearing after they've sunk to the ground, or more prosaically, after you've ignored them in previous chapters and left them somewhere, forgotten, then yeah, they may spawn in these locations. But I don't think it was planned. Oh my god. Ned?
You... Oh, God. You fell. Your stuff gave up. You're Brian Goodwin.
Oh, I can't call that in. There's no reception in the cave. Broken climbing gear. Oh, my God. How did... haven't seen through that exit. Well... I'm sorry, Brian. This is the best I can do for you. Sorry, dude. What's with this skin? Well, you have faltered, I may yet succeed. What happened to Ned Goodwin? Because I see that his son is dead over here. But what about Ned? They've just departed, allegedly, right? So what happened? Where did his father go? Oh no, did both of them go to the cave in a hurry? Well, if Brian fell, wouldn't have Ned been inclined to, you know, help him in some capacity? Now, I understand that you may have some misgivings about him as a father, but seriously. Let's not overdo it. Will this collapse underneath my feet? Let's hope not. I need to be able to come back the way I came in. Because I need to pick up that stupid book. I mean, I could have just gone in and retrieved it immediately. Should I go back and do that? That'll kill any suspense that still lingers here. So I'd rather first discover what there is to discover, say Ned Goodwin, and then and only then will I head all the way back to retrieve my stupid book. What is this cave complex? What is this place? I guess my muscles ache from merely watching him do this. That's quite a workout. What? No way. That loops back around. Nothing would have been discovered, except for the corpse. Makes no sense. But yeah, that path just allows me to go all the way back to the entrance. So there's nothing more. I need to pick up the book and get it through here. I do apologize for being so single-mindedly obsessed with holding stuff, but I'm not going to leave a good book out here to rot. That's not the most fortunate turn of phrase in these circumstances, is it? Oh, you can't run because you want to maintain some modicum of respect for the corpse. Oh, God damn it, no! Brian, dude, sorry, but screw you. I want to get to my pink book. Oh, you stupid dead little kid. God damn you. Henry, why can't you just act like a normal human goddamn being and cross over the corpse two more times to get the book and bring it back to your lookout tower? What's wrong with you? What is your major malfunction? I finally found the pink book. I've been searching for it this entire time. I've been searching for answers as to its whereabouts for the longest time. Now I finally come upon it, and you refuse to aid me in my quest to collect all the books? You have failed me, Henry. You have disappointed me severely. I wanted to get that book. I didn't want much, but I just wanted to get this silly book. And you were unwilling to do that little for my benefit. Well, I'm going to go back, though, if it is at all possible, and retrieve that stupid book, whether you want it or not. Because, you see, it is perfectly feasible. Perfectly feasible. I will rappel all the way back down. Pick up the book, get all the way back up, and to my lookout tower. Then I'll talk to Delilah about poor little Brian breaking his goddamn neck and dying in a cave, all alone. And afraid. It's going to be an emotional moment for the both of us. It's going to be quite lovely. But I will get my book first. I don't know if there is an achievement. I have no clue. I don't know if I can even get it, considering the circumstances, considering the fact that so many of them have been going through the damn floor and through the damn ground that I may have lost track of quite a few of them. But damn it, I will at least try. If I were to put any more effort into it, I could, obviously, investigate further and try every single, say, box out there. And presumably, they won't show up in those sorts of places. Presumably, they won't show up in the orange deposits that you have already checked, because then you'd be thoroughly confused. Why is there a book, though? Even though I checked this place already. Whereas if you find a book in a new place, you can pretend it's a new copy or something. It's not anyone putting anything there after you have already checked it. As it doesn't seem that plot relevant in and of itself. But yes, I have the book, I will call Delilah, and I'm Audi 5000. When the book disappeared... Is that smoke? Is that a tornado? Tornadoes were not supposed to be a possibility.
Hey, D.
There you are. I've been worrying my ass off.
You need to call search and rescue.
What?
There's a body in the cave. It's Brian Goodwin.
Gotta be fucking kidding me. How does that... What? I don't... How?
He fell.
Climbing, I think, or made to look like a climbing accident.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's just what it was. I mean, he was probably exploring the cave and maybe his rope gave out. But whoever locked me in there probably didn't even know about him.
What about the child corpse?
Delilah, you should have told someone he was out here.
Oh, no.
Stop. Okay, I know.
Maybe he would have...
Henry, you insensitive shit. You don't think I know he'd be alive if it weren't for me?
Didn't occur to me.
I fucking know it's my fault. I'll never forget that it's on me.
My book! Fuck!
But yes, sometimes people do know these things even when they don't say them. Duh. Duh. Oh, I'm packing my things and taking the... And I'm taking the typewriter with me.
You see that plane?
Keep the cassette.
No, I was just busy packing up.
Well, there's gonna be a lot more. The service says this thing is 2% contained.
Is this the big fire or the site fire or...
Well, the two fires merged into one unmitigated disaster. They're renaming it after my lookout. You about packed up?
Shouldn't we talk for a sec, you know, about things?
About what?
About how all this stuff is connected. The surveillance, the Goodwins, Brian's death.
I don't honestly know.
Look, I don't know what to say, okay? It's like the universe cooked up the cruelest thing to have happen. Does it connect to everything else? I don't know. I don't know if I even want to.
Of course you do. There's gotta be a reason.
Does there?
Maybe. Maybe not. I wouldn't even know where to begin.
It's beeping.
Well, fuck. For starters, I guess you could find the source of that signal.
Holy crap. Yeah. Oh my god.
We don't know what it is. It could be nothing.
Yeah, it could also be whoever was listening to us. Whoever made the tape.
Okay. Yeah, look, you should pack up everything you need in case we get the call and you can't come back.
Alright, look, if something happens...
I'll remember you.
I was hoping we could have a plan.
I mean, am I walking into a trap right now?
I hope not. I would much rather remember you from a bar somewhere and not a jail cell. Please find who made that tape.
I mean, I've picked up quite a bit. Is there anything else I need? Anything else I could conceivably need? Yes, a granola bar. No. Oh boy, I guess the only way to find out is to head out though. I don't know how this is all connected, I have no clue! Oh, I can't see anything. I don't know where the turtle went. It's probably with me. I don't know how it all is supposed to make sense. Yeah, Brian's body was burnt, wasn't it? So it might have been made to look like an accident, it might not have been an accident whatsoever. I don't know anymore. What about the trail? Could I possibly live through there where there was an avalanche? Now I have to head east then. Presumably there'll be something at the medicine wheel. There was nothing there so far. How about I head east and try to find a way out of here right now instead of following the signal? My goodness. This presumably must have been frustrating to watch. Not as frustrating as, not as frustrating as was to play. Well, not necessarily, but, but presumably, if you know what's up, then it must have been a frustrating experience if you expect perfection, optimization, etc. Whatever the answers, because I was not consistent. So no matter what the answer might be, I couldn't have been on the right path all along. Because I wasn't always on the same track. Oh no, don't tell me they've lost the signal. I haven't. Stop running. Start thinking. very careful. I don't care if they wanted to kill me. They would have done so a long time ago. So for whatever reason, they're not interested in that. I don't know what this is about. I don't think we'll as much set up here anything. After all, we were the test subjects, weren't we? So as long as that part's true and I'm not just insane, then that's at the very least the part that really matters. So we were test subjects, they were listening in on our conversations, and it was some sort of a psychological experiment, but they were also measuring all sorts of other bizarre things. This is the earthquakes? Or were they looking for volcanic activity? What were they looking for? They seem to have been measuring the soil as well. And then there was Brian's body and the cave. The cave was locked. Why? Because of Brian's body? Because the body was dumped there? Was it that lady that lost the key? Or was the key stolen from that lady? By whom? By Ned Goodwin? Was Ned Goodwin behind this? Or did he just get disappeared in the process of all of this? I'm headed towards the lake. Am I? It's so hard to see.
What's your status?
I think I'm getting close.
Alright, well, I just got word that they are coming to get us. My place.
I can get them.
You sound worried.
No, it's just...
Brian?
I'll coordinate with the evac team and let you know when to head towards the tram. It's north. Far. Past where you found that cut back in May. There's an emergency tram out there that will let you hike to the rendezvous point at my lookout.
I know what it is. But I want answers first. Maybe that's the wrong thing to do. But I don't just want to head for the evac. Even if I am to die here, pointlessly. Northwest. Where am I? Because of all these obscured landmarks, I've really lost track of things. I think I'm headed towards the lake. And if this is getting so close, that I might just have my back to it right there now. Which is not a comforting thought. I have to be mindful not to just watch my instruments. Yeah, looking at the tracker is fine and dandy, but I also need to keep track of whatever's in front of me. What? Okay. What's this one? Ned Goodwin.
We've been causing each other a lot of headaches. Now I gotta go stake out a site that's as fit for living as the one you're about to find. You'll get it when you see it. You can't blame me for keeping an eye on you. Not after bumping into you back in May. Down by the cave, for fuck's sake. I've been up here for 3 years. I kept it cozy. Winters are harsh as hell, and ran out of books, but I got that antenna rigged up, and Delilah, she's a record you don't gotta flip. I kinda get why Brian took to her. About a week ago, I stopped worrying about you finding anything out, and that's right when everything went shit house. house with you two.
What?
You guys don't know anything about having kids. All right, nobody knows nothing. It ain't Andy and Opie walking down a lake to fish every afternoon. It ain't Mayberry. But you gotta know I didn't kill him. All right, we were climbing. I was teaching him. Brian was uneducated in the way to do anything. He just fucking didn't sink his anchor the right way. You know, I thought about going back, having to answer questions and having to get him put in the ground, and I didn't see the point. Don't come looking for me. Sorry about your wife.
Jesus Christ, he actually did not come back for his son's corpse.
We found the surveillance operation.
Okay, what does that mean? What is it?
It was Ned Goodwin. He was the one listening to us, just him.
I don't believe that. That doesn't make sense.
Ned Goodwin? He made the tape?
Yeah.
No!
He's gone. Deeper into the Shoshone. He doesn't want anyone to know he's out here.
No, that doesn't make sense!
Because he killed Brian. Because he killed his fucking son.
He didn't.
You need to get back here. They say the helicopters are making rounds.
Okay.
Where did I find the tape? Because there's rope up here. No! No! I'm going up though. Whatever the hell this is. Wherever the hell it leads. Ned didn't do this! This doesn't make sense! Look, I understand the idea. Fine, he might have been, you know, appreciating this voyeuristically. Might have been an intriguing experience for him. But I don't believe that. I don't believe it meshes with everything else that I know. It just doesn't make bloody sense. If it was Ned Goodwin doing all of that, then what about those notes out there? What about that research station that had notes on us in particular? That doesn't quite make sense now, does it? This is Thunder Canyon, right? So I'm north of that. Oh, no, these are, yeah, you can see on the map, the trail. This is a new spot, unexplored, as I had anticipated, but I need to find out what the hell is going on. There's no way Ned Goodwin would have been in it alone. It really doesn't make sense. It doesn't explain the entire story. Danger, trail closed.
I guess he's been dumping trash up here for a while.
She's presumably going to tell me, Henry, hurry, they're evacuating us. Fuck that! They can find me or they can leave me to die.
There's a clothesline.
Dee, do you have no concern for human life? None whatsoever? Do you honestly don't care if I live or die at this point? I think I have one photograph left.
God.
What?
No, Nothing, just some of Brian's stuff.
This could be my... The supplies, son of a bitch! It's been stealing them.
Brian was a nice looking kid.
I could make the final photograph here, but what if there's something else? What if there's something more? I'm not going to make the last photo be this one. Sleeping back from teens camps. Wow, what the hell? Winter needs propane, backup firewood, jackets, blankets, books. Did you steal the panties too? Did you need them? I don't get it. I really don't get it. Subject Delilah, program status review.
Goodwin was the one who wrote the reports I found at the site.
Was he though? What? Or is he being a patsy here? Henry, program status. Observational traits. Fuck. Guilty. Yes, observational traits. Fuck. Research site info. How to break in. Staff return on the 10th of August. Return borrowed equipment. Erase hard drive... Erase hard drive evidence? H plus D evidence? Leave no trace? Okay, it's starting to sink in. You know, making photos of this isn't as valuable as just bringing it with me. If my camera gets stolen, I get Jack anyway. Okay, so all in all, there wasn't some crazy extensive experiment going on. It was just Ned Goodwin doing all that nonsense after breaking into the research station.
He wrote down everything he did to us, and everything he did every day. He was scared shitless.
Damn! Program status review, reliable, observant, charismatic. Never. Fuck. So I guess he was trying to make it look like a report that would throw us off his scent, to make it look like there is some bizarre experiment going on. So pretty much all those notes, all those sorts of things, even that that typed up thing left at the PO box at the research station was of his doing. This is the electronic junk he's gathered. That he ripped out, among other things, from the snowmobile. My goodness, what the hell?
You should see some of the stuff he was working on. I guess he had a lot of time on his hands. This boombox looks familiar.
I'm sorry. I don't know what to say. I don't know what you want me to say.
Delilah.
We're in the middle of a fire that is at 22,000 acres and growing. Fast.
It's gonna burn all of this up.
Well, take a picture if you're so keen to remember it.
You're not?
I don't know.
This is the last photo I can take. Oh my goodness, I should have been more frugal. Should have wasted film.
He was rigging up stolen batteries to keep his stuff going.
She doesn't care? Dee, what the... Dee, listen to me, this is closure, goddammit.
He had quite the view.
See this room. A nicely locked. Affectionate parents to a sweet child. Affectionate lovers and ideal marriage. And up and coming real estate agents. Name themselves in Whistle Creek's newest power couple. And they've just bought the dream home. Everything's perfect for the Locke family. But when the son, Steven, is crushed in the backyard by an old oak tree, his empty bedroom becomes irresistibly alluring to the mourning parents. Fears, sorrows, dreams, fantasies, and more all emanate from Steven's room. If Steven were to return, what if he wants his room back? And what if Steven wasn't so sweet anymore? First, the sorcerer of human suffering and suspense could get enough. Yeah. Now, unfortunately, I can't take this with me. Exactly. 9 lives lost. Yes, the 9th novel. What am I supposed to bring this back to the... This makes no sense. Neil Black's first day of retirement could have gone better, but I found the final book. It began with Neil shot in the chest and left for dead. Now, after decades of bringing hundreds of the nastiest element of South Sea to justice, Neil is unfavored, no leads and only a stray that refused to leave his apartment. A stray cat? Who could want Neil Black dead? The question might be, who wouldn't? 9 lives lost. Neil is at the surface of the danger McCune he's ever had. Himself. The final Nick Black book. Damn it. The radio log. First range in the fly fishing at Jay Lake. Reminder. Rainbow shitting. Cod flies. So Mama Grizzly on morning hike. What? I'm not going to read out all of this aloud. So if you want to go ahead and read it. I haven't left base in 2 weeks. 3 weeks. New lookout in Twofolds. Henry, Twofolds. So Twofolds coming out of cave. Delilah calling for hiker's list. Delay her, she'll forget. Hike to BT Point, severed radio communications. Delilah never called for the hiker's list. Re-rigged Delano to pick up Delilah's frequency. Can hear Delilah and Twofold concurrently. Twofold hiked by cave. He seems less interested. The Jules. Twofold is a good guy. Delilah's drunk again. Get a room! Reminder, scout migration due to fire. Fucked up. Do not want to leave. Reminder, hide supplies for migration. D and Twofold suspect conspiracy. Funny, if not dire. Observe and be ready to leave. Ideas. Start working on reports. Recall the comms. Vandalize this tower. And Twofold, try to make remote recording device. University research site. Move. Pit against each other. Well. He only figured out that he had to pit us against each other at this point? That was way too late! I refused to trust her from the beginning, but then I started trusting her when it made no sense to actually distrust her. Stakes too high, no one will believe B was happy. Make DNF less believable. Not crazy? Like wife? Not a good guy. Hey, screw you, buddy! I'm a good guy! No one believed Brian was happy, yeah. Mama Grizzly back. They heard me. Funny, they believe there is a program. Use this.
Yeah!
I mean, there are two possible explanations. There is a program, and they're pretending it's just Ned Goodwin. Because they're so good, you know? Government conspiracy, so brilliant. All Ned actually did all of this and pretended that there's a conspiracy. Report's final, make sure they find them. Okay. Two faults almost caught me on site. Reports worked. Recorded call useful leverage. Found supplies, keys gone. How? Can't let two faults find B. What do you mean, how? The keys were left for me, this makes no sense. Pick up, read, keep. Pick up, read, keep.
He's got a radio base station up here. He was listening to us on that.
Well, this is it, I guess. The final photograph. Take it all in. There will be no more. Guess I can't go through there. Guess there's nothing more to see or do. This is literally it. That's it. Okay, I will take the final... Oh no. The final Neil Black book, please. The nine lives, not Steven's room, the other book. It's gone, Vestin, alright? Gone. Sank to the ground like all the previous books. There's no useful way of retrieving it. Alright, so there was one guy with cabin fever. One really messed up guy. Desperate to convince us of all sorts of nonsensical things. Yes, D's not a bad person. Not by any stretch of the imagination. I mean, she's not a good person either. She's definitely got flaws, but she's not an evil mastermind. She is who she is. And the research station, there's nothing to it. Yeah, I don't think I'll be able to make my way to Wuppity Meadow. So I might as well give up on that. I need to head to Thunder Canyon and make my way west. Make my way east. Although I could try to reach the fence from the other side. Don't think I'll accomplish much. Why did Delilah not respond to any of those attempts at communicating?
I know I should be relieved.
Okay.
Relieved that there's no evidence of us starting that fire. Relieved that we're not crazy. That there wasn't some conspiracy. But I'm not.
Why?
He was a sweet kid. With a shitty father who hid out here like a coward after dumping him in a hole.
Wasn't a good dad.
No fucking shit. But what? I'm sorry. God, it would have been so easy to tell the truth and have him sent home.
That's why
we can't stop thinking about it.
That's why we follow the rules, Delilah. Yeah, but you didn't. Fine!
Tell the truth when they asked you. You didn't send him home.
No.
You just gotta live with it, Delilah. It won't be that hard.
If you say so.
Dee?
Oh, fuck.
Is that a helicopter?
Yeah, hold on. Hey!
They're gonna kill her, aren't they?
Okay, 1 second. Hey, they're here, but they're making rounds. They'll come back. I think I'm gonna go with them.
Don't.
Wait, just wait, okay? I'm not that far.
Henry, they're here. They're waiting right now.
Please.
Henry, I don't want to meet you and just sit here in a dead boy's shadow. Okay, I don't want to do that.
Fine, not fuck you, do whatever you want.
I know that sounds harsh. Okay, I'll wait.
I'm not far.
Okay.
She actually will wait. That's amazing. Fancy that, I actually want her to wait. She made a very compelling argument. They're literally here. They're making rounds. They'll be back. No. I want to meet her, apparently. Fancy that. Yes, I've changed my mind about her. Although I was ruthlessly harsh every step of the way, wasn't I? Just brutal. Am I even going the right way? I think I am. I've made all these shortcuts. Come on, don't lose the way. Yeah, I have stolen university equipment. Yep. You go up this, and then run up north. And then I'll have to rig the thing to be able to leave. Damn, Ned. Was it Ned? Is that my final answer? Is that the most sensible of interpretations? Okay, go through the north. Well, part of it must have been Ned. I found evidence of it being Ned. Cabin fever, little helmet. And all the other stuff? It makes sense in the context of itself. It was a research station, a perfectly reasonable one. They were looking for earthquakes and measuring soil. Makes perfect sense. It was a way to communicate. Oh, this would have been quite somber. Had she left without waiting for me. I still have no guarantee that I'll actually find her over there. I guess all I have is trust. Trust, eh? Trust that I pretty much never had in her to begin with. That I suspected her from the word go. I was pretty positive she was cooking up something diabolical. That her intentions weren't as innocent. So I had originally thought. I've also been quite harsh in pretty much everything I've said to her. I've been honest to an extent, open about a decent bit of stuff, and at the same time, pretty soul-crushingly honest as well. Okay, climbed one, climbed two. Don't go to the supply drop. Instead, go through here. The supply drop is to the west, head east. Well, there we go. It's on my side. I'm here.
Hey, I'm at the evac spot near the ravine. Delilah, are you there? Delilah?
Will I die? Will I be able to cross the ravine, or will this kill me? No map. What's the cable car? I need to orient myself. I know this is not the way I'm supposed to go, so I am going precisely this way. And there's nothing for me to find over there. Not a damn thing. Complete lack of trust. Absolute goddamn paranoia. And yet at the same time, I guess, in hindsight, it's nice to be able to trust someone. It's nice to be able to talk to someone. Gee. She's even got flowers though in a can. How quaint. Excellent, I've inspected her outhouse. Lovely. D.
God, it's a nightmare out there.
Will I die here?
Delilah!
You did not betray me, D, did you? Don't tell me I'll go in and find a note saying goodbye, Henry, or something along those lines. Just because I wasn't, say, particularly nice to her. There's bound to be a note. She said she would wait! Lucian's Gambit. The thrilling continuation of the best-selling series of novels that have gripped the world. When we last joined our hero, he had been separated from his allies by the evil Venom Fang, whose plot to conquer all of the mortal realms is nearing fruition. Lucian and Rax reunite the shards of truth to free Crindle from his entrapment. Oh yeah, bashing nerds really got you far, dude. Quite a few crosswords, more crosswords. Well, I guess the question is, did she leave me here to die? How did she just leave? Was it because I was rude? Was it because they were here? It's all quite neat. Thanks, dude. Just put it down, please. Yes, keep, clearly. No, let's not eat the same apple slice. The only way to go is to... Henry, what do we know? White Schultz. He's got a turtle. I hope he gets eaten by birds that... It's a little station. Burst into flames. Well, I guess I deserve that. Guess I deserve all of it. Fine, the only thing I can do is actually... is the radio. Fine. Where is everyone? Hello?
Hello? Is anybody there?
Hi.
You're not here.
No. Don't be mad.
I'm not.
there for another minute.
It's okay.
I get it.
You do?
I think so.
Hey, it shouldn't take long for the helicopter to reach you.
It's okay.
Okay.
Just made a promise and you broke it.
In a situation like this. Lots of questions.
I'll just tell them the truth.
Shit. So, taking stock, we found out an old lookout killed his only son and decided to become a lonely hermit.
Yes.
And we prevented one fire?
Basically started another.
Okay, so that's a wash.
Oh, I'll have to figure out what I'm doing every summer from now on that isn't this.
You're not coming back?
No. And you'll have to... I don't know.
Yeah, me neither. I don't know what's next.
Tell you what. Why don't you choose for me, and I'll choose for you.
All right, sure. Maybe...
Dude, you've got a wife. Fuck that.
Well, you could always go take over the crossword at the New York Times.
Oh yeah, I could probably fall right into that.
New York, big city.
Couldn't be further from here.
I've never been.
Well, when I end up out there...
Yeah. So, what about me?
I think you should go to Julia.
Yes.
And then you can figure it out. Maybe put that typewriter to good use. Give me a sexy accent or something if you write about this.
I, yeah.
You gotta go see her.
Exactly.
Yeah, sure.
Henry, I... Look, you came out to put your memories behind you, and they're still right there in front of you.
I will go see her! Nope.
You're right. I mean, I think you're right.
Good.
When I get back, maybe I could,
We shouldn't focus on this summer. Next year, we'll roll around, and then the year after that, and then it's just a... I don't know. My Aunt Judy called it a pause in the hallway of time.
Did your Aunt Judy smoke a lot of pot?
Yeah?
Well, you should try to take her advice, too.
Yeah, we'll see.
There's the helicopter.
They'll land back where you hiked up. Good luck, Henry.
You too. Good luck.
No. Henry, you keep it for yourself, okay? Bye, Hank.
Hank. I think I've made pretty much all the wrong choices I could ever have. In the name of responsibility, I've refused to move on a single inch. And it took me a long while to realize it. Long while. I could have potentially tried to head towards some future. Something promising. Something, you know? I could have done something with the rest of my life instead of falling apart in the face of tragedy. Like Ned did, right? He fell apart. And so did I. I mean, I... In a different way, I guess. But then again, I decided responsibility was the way to go. After all, he is a married man. He ought to remain a married man, and... Although that's... That sticks him in an unenviable position. I don't think there's a lot more that can be said about all of this. Almost certainly this can play out better. Or at least differently. Thanks for watching, and you will see me elsewhere. When I saw you and her talking.
Jesus Christ, dude. Oh, those are the photos, of course. They help in nothing. Nothing. They don't matter. Well, just for you. Previous photos.